Alcazar AudioWorks presents a collection of fairy tales from Denmark by Hans Christian Andersen. Read for you by Bobbie Frohman. The Princess and the Pea. Once upon a time, there was a prince who wanted to marry a princess. But she would have to be a real princess. He traveled all over the world to find one, but nowhere could he get what he wanted. There was princesses enough, but it was difficult to find out whether they were real ones. There was always something about them that was not as it should be. So he came home again and was sad, for he would have liked very much to have a real princess. One evening a terrible storm came on, and there was thunder and lightning, and the rain poured down in torrents. Suddenly a knocking was heard at the city gate, and the old king went to open it. It was a princess standing out there in front of the gate. But, good gracious, what a sight the rain and the wind had made her look! The water ran down from her hair and clothes. It ran down into the toes of her shoes and out again at the heels. And yet she said that she was a real princess. "Well, we'll soon find that out," thought the old queen. But she said nothing, went into the bedroom, took all the bedding off the bedstead, and laid a pea on the bottom. Then she took 20 mattresses and laid them on the pea, and 20 eiderdown beds on top of the mattresses. On this, the princess had to lie all night. In the morning, she was asked how she had slept. "Oh, very badly," said she. "I have scarcely closed my eyes all night. Heaven only knows what was in the bed, but I was lying on something hard, so that I am black and blue all over my body. It's horrible." Now they knew that she was a real princess, because she had felt the pea right through the 20 mattresses and 20 eiderdown beds. Nobody but a real princess could be as sensitive as that. So the prince took her for his wife, for now he knew that he had a real princess, and the pea was put in the museum, where it may still be seen, if no one has stolen it. There, that is a true story. The Ugly Duckling. It was lovely summer weather in the country, and the golden corn, the green oats, and the haystacks piled up in the meadows looked beautiful. The stork, walking about on his long red legs, chattered in the Egyptian language, which he had learned from his mother. The cornfields and meadows were surrounded by large forests, in the midst of which were deep pools. It was indeed delightful to walk about in the country. In a sunny spot stood a pleasant old farmhouse, close by a deep river, and from the house down to the waterside grew great burdock leaves, so high that under the tallest of them a little child could stand upright. The spot was as wild as the center of a thick wood. In this snug retreat sat a duck on her nest, watching for her young brood to hatch. She was beginning to get tired of her task, for the little ones were a long time coming out of their shells, and she seldom had any visitors. The other ducks liked much better to swim about in the river than to climb the slippery banks and to sit under a burdock leaf to have a gossip with her. At length one shell cracked, and then another, and from each egg came a living creature that lifted its head and cried, "Beep, beep, beep." "Quack, quack," said the mother. And then they all quacked as well as they could and looked about them on every side at large green leaves. Their mother allowed them to look as much as they liked, because green is good for the eyes.
"How large the world is,"
said the young ducks when they found out how much more room they now had than while they were inside the eggshell.
"Do you imagine this is the whole world?"
asked the mother.
"Wait till you have seen the garden. It stretches far beyond that to the parson's field, but I have never ventured..."
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.